Welcome to another installment of Designing Solar Photovoltaic Systems by James, the Justice and Mercy Engineering Society. Today we're going to talk about battery capacity. A 100 amp hour battery stores a certain amount of charge, and that charge can be described as a product of amps, current, and time in hours. So for example, a battery that supplies 5 amps for 20 hours or is capable of supplying 5 amps for 20 hours is called a 100 amp hour battery. And you might be tempted to think that a 20 amp for 5 hours would also be another way to get 100 amp hours, but it turns out that the battery capacity itself changes depending on the discharge rate. So the 20 hour rate is sort of a standard rate, and so you'll find batteries for sale and the discharge rate is 20 amp hour, or 20 hour rate. But if I take that same 100 amp hour battery and discharge it at a faster rate, such as at 16 amps or 65 amps or 110 amps, what I'll see is the overall capacity will decrease. It won't hold as much charge if I take the charge out at a faster rate. For clarity, I should say that the horizontal axis on this curve is time and the vertical axis is capacity. Capacity, you could also think of that as just total charge that can be stored in the battery. So let me label these axes here. Now the reason that battery capacity diminishes as you discharge the battery faster is because, see, over here on the left I'm drawing the battery plate. Remember, the plate might be lead dioxide or lead, depending on if it's a cathode or anode, and it's equally true for both. So this is a close-up of the lead plate, and at a microscopic level, over here on the left, you have these little pores. These little indentations are like pores in the surface, and that's to increase the surface area. On the right is the liquid electrolyte. On the left is the solid battery plate. The electrolyte is the it could be water if it's mostly discharged, or a mixture of water and sulfuric acid. So why is this? Well, as the reaction occurs and the battery starts discharging, little bits of lead sulfate, PbSO4, form on the surface of the battery plate. And as this chemical process happens, especially if it happens very quickly, then the lead sulfate, PbSO4, will actually bridge over the pore and diminish the usable surface area of the plate. If we diminish the usable surface area of the plate by covering these pores, then we decrease the overall amount of material that's available for the chemical reaction. Does no permanent damage to the battery. It just means that on this particular discharge, you don't get as much energy if you did it very quickly. When you recharge the battery, this process is reversed and the pores are unbridged, so there's no permanent damage done. I hope this is helpful. Ha ha ha!